All right, here we are. Algoma country. Fishing in early September, Chapleau Lodge on Borden Lake. And John Pegg, the owner here, I mean, he's got people come all from the States, all over the world here. But obviously with that virus issue and stuff, you people are watching this, think about this year. And think about the opportunities up here in places like Chapleau. They've got so many different species. You know, whitefish, northern pike, walleye, smallmouth. And that's what I'm gonna be chasing on this trip up here in Chapleau. Now the minnow swim baits with the underspin, just phenomenal little look. You know, you got that little blade kicking and stuff. And I'm gonna fish these areas. You can see with the wind behind me, that turbulent water. So I have to let it fall, engage, and just start cranking it. Making that little spin, turn, make that little tail wobble. When big smallmouth see this, they're gonna eat it. But I gotta put it in areas that I see that look like ambush spots on rocky points, edges, ledges, rock shoals and reefs and stuff. This here will catch me some good smallmouth. Yeah, they crushed it. Where are you, pike? Smallmouth? Could be a smallmouth, could be pike. Smallmouth. Whew. You like the minnow bait, huh? They can't resist a minnow bait right there. Whew. Good way to start on Borden Lake, huh? Oh boy. Yeah, man. You saw that swimming minnow bait. You had to eat it, didn't you? Nice, chunky, beautiful smallmouth, hey? On the fall, too. Look where that hook is. A little underspin. Woof. That's a good way to start here in the first week of September, up here in beautiful Chapleau. I'll put a few in the box for pictures and stuff, but you know that stuff right here? Rocks. And I'm in a little saddle between two islands. Get rewarded with one of Ontario's finest. Beautiful smallmouth bass. Chunky fish, and they're just a little moody. Been windy for 3-4 days. The water went from 70 to 59 this morning. Try top water, not happening yet. So subsurface, we'll find a way to catch them to inspire you to think about Chapleau Lodge, these beautiful brown bass. You got a lean back set hook. You got that heavy gauge hook. You see that? So I use a St. Croix 7-1 medium heavy. And I got on this 14 pound gamma fluorocarbon. Man, that wind is definitely an issue, but I want to fish. And I'm going to go to areas now that potentially I can use a little tube jig, which are shoals, reefs, in the middle of deep water. They come up to about 4 or 5 feet of water. Prime areas for feeding smallmouth. The water's cold, like it's only 58 degrees. They're just there. So it's just like a mushy, weird feeling. And sometimes all you see is just that line, a really small twitch, or just something looks different, looks like it hit the bottom, but you know you're in 12 feet of water and it's only about 5-6 feet down. When that happens, don't hesitate. Set, lift, catch. So every time you pitch, head of the boat, maybe 25 feet. Remember, I'm dissecting these rocks and these edges and stuff for these shoals. So just cast, watch your line going down. The good thing about the micro tube, you can cover the whole water column. You snap, watch it. Snap, watch it. Very important. Watch the line, catch way more bass.
This is the kind of area I like, dude. Right here. He's not big, but he's a smallmouth. And he shows me that this is where they are. Look how tough these Borden Lake smallmouth are. Look at him. He's putting on the beef. Look at him. He's just... Wow, would you ever act like you got attitude, man? That's why I like you, smallmouth. This is why you folks come for it. Right here, his girth, or his belly is almost like the length. Look at that fish. Just a fat little smallmouth. Ready? Go on, boy. Little tube jig, and just pitching it out, snapping. I'm in 10 feet. I started around that deep water basin. It just wasn't happening. I got one decent fish, had a few other snaps. But he come up, and sometime in September, it's not about getting up at 5 o'clock. It's about going out and peak bite. And I find up north in Ontario that I'd say 11 to 3 is fantastic. You get a really good heat spell for a couple of days, 4 or 5. You can even throw top water after dinner and come out and catch some fish. But finding them, shallower water, Those are feeding fish. The warmer water's got the bait right now. They're still eating. And snapping a little tube is catching some bass for me.